everyone. Today we have with us Tripti Nachne as the featured consultant from IMPA Thane. Welcome, Tripti. Thanks for being with us here.
Thank you, Purnima. Thanks for having me, IMPA Thane, as the featured consultant this time. Very nice to see you, Purnima, after a really long time.
Same here, Tripti. It's such a pleasure to be able to see each other. And I really look forward that we're able to see each other again in real. I think this virtual thing is really getting too much. And because
I think we're all used to it now. We're all used to it now, looking at each other through screens.
Yes, absolutely. In fact, I know quite a few people who are trying to cut down on their screen time off late now that there's a lot happening virtually, which is why I'm going to jump straight to the interview, straight to our questions and conversation. So, Tripti, you are an engineer and you've also done your master's in management from Symbiosis.
Yes.
You were into marketing. So, how did image consulting happen? Like, what got you excited about this industry?
Okay, so back then I was very much into a marketing career in different industries. I worked with many different corporates like L&T. And then I switched to IDEA after my marketing management. Post that, I had taken a sabbatical and was going through the newspapers. A lot of times, ITBI was coming up. And, I started reading up a lot more on image management and image consulting. Back then in my marketing, or in my career, I was doing branding. But I was doing product branding. And this talked a lot about branding, but it was more of personal branding. So that really excited me about, the transition that I could possibly make from product to a personal branding kind of a scenario. So that was number one. All through my life, through my, study years and from college and career, one thing I knew was that I was very comfortable in interpersonal communication. So whether it was presenting anything, connecting with people. So that was something that came naturally to me. So I didn't have to work harder. So I put these two things together and I felt that, I should really give this a try. That was one. And the other thing, Purnima, was when I joined the course, when I finally took up the course, the sheer depth of knowledge and the kind of comprehensive curriculum that we got at ICBI was another level. And that really interested me. That was when I made a decision that, this is something that I really want to do. Further as well. And then once I started getting training offers, there was no looking back. And I really started loving my job. And that was how, I got excited to get into this very exciting industry. So, it's been great.
I'm sure that feels absolutely wonderful to be able to follow your heart and do something that's aligned with your passion and your strengths, right?
Yeah.
So that's really great to know. But then I would also like to understand, so you got to follow your heart, you got to follow your passion when you stepped into the image consulting space. But is it also something as lucrative, you would say, one of the most lucrative professions around?
Okay. So Purnima, that's a great question. So I've been in the industry for the past 7 years now. I have seen the industry grow in a great manner. So back then, I remember that a lot of our work was towards creating awareness about this industry. Whether it was to do with people, when you're talking to people, people were unaware about what an image consultant does. Corporates also, they were just, they knew about soft skills, but they didn't know about image management. So a lot of our work was more of putting it into awareness. Now that decade is gone, and now I feel that a major chunk of awareness job is done. Now the onus is on us to service all the needs that have arisen out of these kind of awareness programs that have gone in all these years. So whether it is the need of personal excellence for a person or a professional, or whether it's a corporate, or if it's any kind of social and emotional learning for a child, whether it's a children or an educational institution. And of course, you have your styling and fashion space. So there are so many different things that an image consultant does. And if you look at so many consultants now, and there's so much different variety of work people are doing, I would totally go by that, you know, what you said, that it is definitely a lucrative career for today's times. So I agree to that.
Great. I'm sure it feels so great to belong to such a fraternity.
Yes.
Especially you're such a senior member. You've been certified for over 7 years now. I think you were certified in 2013. And you're one of the senior most consultants around from the fraternity. So what kind of work are you doing right now? So for the aspiring consultants, what can they actually look forward to when they gain more experience in the fraternity? So what kind of work are you engaged in?
So everyone's journey is different, Purnima, and my journey also has been unique, I would say. So since I started off, so once I got certified, I started my own venture, Identity, the Image Management Studio. I started off doing individual consultation. The main people that would come to me were mainly professionals, entrepreneurs who were, you know, starting up something new, where they need to go and present themselves in front of investors and they need to make that mark. So these are the kind of people that I was catering to. Slowly and steadily, I got into doing a lot of different programs, even on individual, with individual consultations. Even public speaking programs were done individually. So like, for example, there's a professional who knows her work really well, whether she's a dietitian or a nutritionist. But when she wants to go and deliver in front of a crowd, she would probably take help of me to put together her entire speech module and then present it well. Okay, so that is one example. Slowly and steadily, I started working with children in a different space. It was more of social and emotional learning. And the results I was getting out of that was a great motivator for me to go on with a lot of passion in that space as well. So that was another thing that I was doing. So of course, there were a lot of teenage empowerment programs that we worked on. So that was one space. With corporates, of course, I was doing corporate grooming and a lot of executive presence programs. So these were the the different arenas that I was working on. However, an image consulting space is not definitely limited to this. There's so much more that people, like you said, talked about aspiring image consultants. There are a lot of consultants who are a lot into styling. So there's that entire space open as well. People are doing personal shopping. So there are so many different things that people do. Okay. Other than that, of course, I have been training at ICBI as a faculty member. And that has kept me very much in touch with my subject and, all the different topics. And it's great to teach aspiring image consultants as well. So all in all, it has been a great journey for me working in these different areas.
Oh, I can see that. You've been working with a variety of audience, right? From, kids to grown-ups to individual consulting and even corporates. That's really very aspirational, I'm sure, for a lot of, emerging consultants.
Purnima, also I feel that, so initially, of course, all this work happened by myself and, being a freelancer. But then over the time, I think I realized that something that worked really well for me was having meaningful collaborations with experts from different industries. So if I was working in a fashion and styling space, I had collaborated with someone who was a style consultant. When I was working with children, that was an entirely different venture altogether because I didn't want to mix the two. But that different venture was in collaboration with someone who was an expert in that field. It was a Heal Your Life trainer that I collaborated with. Very recently, I've also collaborated with a mind trainer, and we are putting together image and mind. So that is some, and I enjoy working with these different experts from different fields. So I think I love doing that, exploring new things.
I think that's a very powerful point that you bring forth, Tripti, that, collaboration is the new way to be, that's the way forward, where you can bring in some expertise from your end and collaborate with the right people.
Yes. Would you that's say very exciting. That
awareness about image consulting in general, and also specifically amongst people, amongst corporates, the level of awareness that has, that's how it's become now. Does that also affect these collaborative experiences. It's easier to find and make collaborations. What do you think about the level of awareness now as compared to how it was before?
The level of awareness, Purnima, has increased tremendously, I must say. Like I said, you know, earlier we were building awareness, but now we are servicing all the needs that have arisen. I can just cite a very recent example of a magazine where I got featured recently. So that's a completely corporate magazine, and they did a special feature on image consultants. So, and these are the magazines that meant for CXO level people. And so if you can, you know, have an entire feature for an entire magazine for all image consultants specially. So I think you can, you know, it just talks how much importance that they are giving to the entire subject and how much their employees can benefit out of it. So yeah, there are two kinds of corporates, I can say. One who really know what they want from us, you know, they'll tell you this is the kind of professional training that I want. Whereas there's another set of people who would who are more open to ideas from consultants like us, and they would put out the platter in front of us, okay, what it is that you can do for our people. So yes, but overall the awareness has increased tremendously.
Oh, great. But congratulations for, you know, for the feature, because I think that's a great achievement to be featured in one of the CXO magazines. I think that's really nice.
Yes, thank you. Thank you.
So, Tripti, we've seen you do a variety of work. You've been working with children. You've been working with individuals, corporates, like we just spoke. You've also been styling a few events which are about women empowerment. I've been seeing that as well. So what can we hope and expect and look forward to seeing you doing in the near future? Do you have any projects lined up? Do you have like a path forward in mind, a certain space that you would like to venture out? What can we expect?
I think, Nima, what has happened is in this pandemic situation, a lot of thinking has been going on. So how the world has all come together as one, thanks to technology. Something that I look forward to is having more international exposure. So in terms of training in and taking our business outside of India, that was something that I look forward to. Other than that, I'm working on certain projects in collaborations, like I mentioned before. So hoping for those to get into completion soon. So few things are lined up. Yeah, definitely.
Lovely. We look forward to hearing about that. And thank you so much for your time, Tripti. It was lovely talking to you.
Thank you, Purnima, for having me. It was really a pleasure. Thank you.
My pleasure.